The fighting further intensifies in Ukraine as Russian forces fired dozens of rockets in the city of Kherson. Ukraine's military says Moscow targeted civilians in the area after it launched over 30 rockets early Wednesday. There are no details yet on the number of casualties. But Ukraine officials add Russia is attacking populated areas and is deploying more tanks on the front lines in Kherson. Moscow lost Kherson to Ukrainian forces in November in what was largely viewed as a huge setback to its invasion of Ukraine. Now, China vows to step up its COVID response as it grapples with a new outbreak. Authorities say they will ramp up COVID vaccinations among senior citizens and ensure there will be enough medicine supply for the elderly. They also look to strengthen preventive measures in health facilities and in schools. Officials add ventilation and disinfection will be improved in key sectors such as transportation and public utilities. Afghanistan's sweeping restrictions on women receives condemnation from the United Nations Security Council. The council said Tuesday it was deeply alarmed by the ruling Taliban's move to ban women from attending universities or working for humanitarian aid groups. The council calls it a representation of an increasing erosion for the respect of human rights and fundamental freedoms. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, for his part, says actions to exclude and silence women continue to cause major setbacks to the potential of the Afghan people. North Korea's Kim Jong-un hints at another year of weapons tests as he unveiled Pyongyang's military goals for 2023. Kim spoke Wednesday at the annual meeting of the ruling Workers' Party. The local broadcaster, KCNA, reports he sought a review of the situation in the Korean Peninsula. Kim also outlined Pyongyang's aim to strengthen its self-defensive capabilities next year. North Korea's fired an unprecedented number of missiles this year, launches that drew concern and condemnation from the international community. An infectious diseases expert believes bivalent vaccines will be a big help to the country's pandemic response as it offers better protection to the vulnerable populations such as senior citizens and immunocompromised individuals. Dr. Ronjin Solante says compared to monovalent vaccines, the bivalent jabs from Pfizer and Moderna are not seen to cause any adverse events after immunization.
There is advantage and benefit with bivalent vaccines, especially now with the Omicron subvariants, the dominant subvariant of concern in most countries. And not only it protects us against symptomatic infection, but also it can protect us against severe infection, especially for those vulnerable population, the 65 years old and above.
Philippine drug regulators issued last week the emergency use authorization for Moderna and Pfizer's bivalent vaccines. The health department hopes to purchase these jabs next year. In the meantime, the agency says it will continue to administer the monovalent COVID vaccines. The Philippines' anti-graft court denies Janet Lim Napolis' bid to block evidence in one of her pork barrel scam cases. The case involves former Oriental Mindoro representative Rodolfo Valencia and the anomalous use of a $7 million Priority Development Assistance Fund from 2007 to 2009. The Sandigan Bayan 7th Division admitted documents, including printouts of whistleblower Benhur Luis' hard drive, as well as check disbursement reports. Napolis had objected to their admission, citing irrelevance. But the court said the files were offered to prove that Napolis's illegal transactions, coursed through various non-government organizations, were recorded and documented. Napolis is in jail after she was convicted of plunder in 2018.